bring you a 3-minute digest of what happened in China's business sector. This is China Business Now by 21st Century Business Herald. Hi everyone, I'm Stephanie Lee. Let's dive in with today's top stories. China's National Development and Reform Commission, or the NRDC, stated on Monday that coal prices will start a downward trend in and after July. The NRDC adopted multiple measures to ensure coal supply and stabilize prices, including increased coal production and supply, promote the release of high-quality production capacity, release coal reserves, and strengthen the supervision of the performance of medium and long-term contracts. As of last Saturday, all 31 provinces in China have announced the 2021 college entrance examination admission scores. Under the college entrance exam reform, the scores announced by some provinces this year only clarify the line 1 and line 2 instead of the first tier and second tier in previous years. In terms of the division of liberal arts and sciences, some provinces use physics and history as the division. In many provinces, the admission scores of liberal art are going upward and that of science are going downward. Update on COVID-19. The Chinese mainland reported 21 new COVID-19 cases on Sunday, all from overseas. CBC leads a century's progress. China is now a world leader in science and technology. When the People's Republic of China was founded in 1949, the country only had around 50,000 technological personnel, but China began to catch up fast. In 1964, the country successfully detonated its first atomic bomb, making China the fifth nuclear-armed nation. And in 1970, China launched its first space satellite, Dongfang Hong 1. Space exploration has been fast expanding on multiple areas. In 2003, China became the third nation to send an astronaut into space, after Russia and the US. In 2019, its Chang'e 4 mission made the world's first ever soft landing on the far side of the moon, a milestone in humanity's lunar exploration. And its homegrown Mars probe Tianhe 1 is aiming to have an all-round study of the red planet's geography after being launched in July 2020. Since 2013, China has been the world's second largest investor in research and development spending, after the US. And moving on with industry news, China's industrial profits soared by 83.4% year-on-year during the first 5 months to about 3.4 trillion yuan, thanks to stable recovery of demand, data from the National Bureau of Statistics showed on Sunday. Compared with the first 5 months of 2019, the figure represented a rise of 48%. The average growth rate in the past 2 years stood at 21.7%. Chinese authorities have rolled out fresh measures on Friday to cut fees on transactions and payment services as part of efforts to ease the burdens on market entities and boost the real economy. Based on surveys of nearly 50,000 small, micro, and individual businesses, 4 government agencies, including the central bank and the top economic planner, introduced 12 fee cut policies on basic payment services. The policies covering areas including bank account services and RMB transactions will take effect on September 30. China's software and information technology sector maintained its growth momentum in the first 5 months of the year, official data shows. The sector's combined software revenue rose 22.6% year-on-year to 3.39 trillion yuan in the January to May period. The growth rate fell 2.4% from its level in the first 4 months, according to the Ministry of Industry and Information Technology. Switching gears to the financial sector, China remained one of the leading IPO markets in the world in the first half of 2021, accounting for 29% of the world's total by deal number and proceeds, according to Ernst & Young. It is estimated that the Shanghai Stock Exchange ranked the second among global bosses in terms of IPO deals after Nasdaq. And wrapping up with a quick look at the stock market. Chinese stocks closed mixed on Monday, with the benchmark Shanghai Composite Index down 0.03% at 3,506 points. The Shenzhen Component Index closed 0.98% higher at 15,150 points. Stocks related to pork, Chinese medicine and semiconductor led the gains, while shares related to coal mining, banking and securities saw losses. That's it for today. Tune in tomorrow on China Business Now by 21st Century Business Herald. Goodbye.